last release we do then.
Oh, I love that song.
Yes, it's got 16,500 views on Spotify.
Yeah, yep. Just a little nail that song. I love it.
I love it too.
And Daphne did harmonies on that one as well.
So we're beautiful together, Daphne.
Yeah. Perfect combo.
They're a good team.
Cheers to us.
Cheers.
So there's no turning back, another day gone by, and what was that one too? Oh, For Hannah. For Hannah.
Yeah.
Which Daphne did backing vocals once again. Yeah. Okay. And I'm working another song featuring the two of you at the moment.
Yes, you are.
It's called Waiting.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh. So you'll be waiting for that one? Just
yes.
Progressing slowly.
Waiting a while.
About
already.
Halfway through the tracks at the moment. It's a very difficult song to get together. But both of you, I gave just for a bit of an inkling what the song's going to be about. It's going to be about sexting and texting.
Yes.
Yeah. Sending emails.
Okay. So I'm basically going to be like a stalker.
Well, you're both going to be stalkers.
Oh, no. Nice.
Daphne's singing as well, so.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, I think we got this.
But you'll be singing the nice lady-like parts, isn't it?
And I'll be singing the not-so-nice part.
That's right.
Okay.
The naughty bit. Okay. I might change it around a little bit as we get into it.
I don't mind. I'll sing what I can do.
Brilliant.
Okay. The face is me.
Now we're flitting on to Daphne again. Daphne, you told me before you started singing professionally when you were 15. Can you tell me about some of your best moments performing live in your life?
My best moments is when I was performing in Dubai. We do perform every night, and we only have like once a week day off. It's very memorable moments to me. Dubai.
Okay, so you're treated well over there?
Yeah, really good.
Good.
I perform different hotels.
Yeah.
I've
been to Dubai. I love Dubai.
It's beautiful, right? I'd love to go back there.
Elegant.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you had a nice moment not that long ago too, I remember.
No, which one?
When you went back to the Philippines.
Oh yeah, I went to the Philippines to visit my family. Is it just for only 3 days? My main purpose to go there is to go Manila. Just went to a club. And then one of my bandmates before was performing, but at night. And then, oh, Daphne, you're already back. And I was like, yeah, but I'm not performing here, okay? I'm just an audience. I just.
But you took over.
Yeah, because my bandmates would tell me, you should perform. You should, oh, Daphne, here's Daphne, one of my co-singers.
You can't help yourself.
Yeah, she just dropped on the stage and just pushed people out of the way. And I'm here. No, I know you really enjoyed that.
Yeah, I had a good time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jessica, when did you start singing, apart from the show?
Ever since, I think, like, I was 10 years old, I remember just singing and dancing in front of the TV, you know, when they have the music on the TV, the music videos. I'd always just copy, like, Britney or Christina Aguilera. I love that kind of stuff, so, yeah, or Rihanna. So yep. That's basically when I started singing.
Yeah.
And I was just because I've got a bit of a unique voice, I was always very shy to show people my voice. So I just sang in private. So I've not really done any performing, but I'm going to be doing performing with Daphne.
Yes!
Yes, definitely it's going to happen.
It's going to happen. Watch out.
Okay. So, Jessica, once again, who inspired you both to sing this other 53? Maybe off the top of your head, maybe think of about 10 people, different artists, whatever.
I'd say I really liked Britney Spears, and I really was into Avril Lavigne. I really wanted to be like her.
Yeah.
And Christina Aguilera. Anyone who's got like a powerful voice, I really admire.
Okay. Yeah. Daphne?
Tina Turner, Beyonce.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of course.
My favorite.
Okay. But you like some other weird stuff too, like Astrid Gilberto.
Astrid Gilberto.
Yeah.
And who's that singer? Chaka Khan, and the one who just recently passed away. She's a famous jazz singer, the one who sang Respect.
Aretha Franklin.
Yeah, Aretha Franklin.
Yeah. Ah. I'm just about to start listening to her, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got every single one of her albums on Spotify. I've got them all on the big playlist. I'm going to be going through them and one by one, allocating them off to my own playlist. I'm looking forward to that. She actually sang, apart from being an R&B singer, that she's mainly famous for, she also, people know that she did gospel and did jazz and also blues, so she was really versatile. Yeah.
Oh, she did some gospel songs.
Yeah. There was an album, it's on Spotify, 1956 I think it was recorded. First thing, it's the whole album's just gospel. Because she was besides music, what other hobbies, interests do you have? Let's start with Jessica.
Where do I start? So
dressing up in weird costumes.
Yes. So I'm very into getting into acting and modelling. So I'm with an agency, a fantastic acting agency called Sergi Management. And through them, I've managed to get some work and working as a stand-in on some movie sets and TV shows or as an extra. So that's been amazing. I mean, when you see yourself on TV, it's just like, wow, look at me. There I am, that little dot over there.
And you've had bit appearances in some very famous series, I believe, haven't you?
Yes, I was in Upright.
Yeah, yes. Upright.
Yeah, you saw me. I was walking to the airport.
That's right.
Just the back of my head.
Yeah. What you do, you always make an impact.
And there's another TV show, it's called Boys Swallows Universe. It's not out yet.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm gonna be in that one.
Okay.
What do you do
in that one?
I'm just sat, I don't really know if I can really talk much about it.
So. Okay, that's fine. That's all right.
So,
I can talk about the video you're on, though.
Yes, I was in a music video for Marion Vaughan, it's called Baby, and I'm riding a motorbike.
How did that come about, Jessica?
Oh, just through my amazing agency. They were looking for a female who can ride a motorbike, and I was just like, here I am. Mm-hmm. So, because there's not many women who can ride motorbikes, it narrowed it down quite well. So, lucky for me, I got chosen.
I thought you were the best thing in that video, honestly.
Oh, did you really? Yeah.
You know how to ride a bike?
Of course.
Oh, no. I have a license. You play so well.
You know how to ride a bike as well?
Oh,
we'll go for a ride together, Dad. So I start in the middle of the video. Yeah. My friend Ashley, who was like the main hero role in the video, he's amazing. And then I just come in at the middle at the petrol station scene. I had a great time. That was the best time I've ever had on set. It was so much fun.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, and I've also done a bit of modelling as well. I'm actually going to do a Halloween photo shoot after this interview today. So I'm going to be dressed up as a vampiric bride. I've got a wedding dress and I dyed it black and it's going to be awesome.
And you'll send me some pics which I'll post on some
stuff. Yes, I also played a violin, Bruce.
Yes, that's right.
What else have I missed out?
I forgot to mention that Jessica played violin on Broken Heart.
I did.
Yeah.
And then what else do I do? I forgot now.
You've forgotten your martial arts.
Oh, jiu-jitsu! Oh my god, how could I forget about that? I love Brazilian jiu-jitsu. But recently, I've injured my knee, so I've got a fractured patella.
And how does that happen?
This girl, I was already beating her. I only won one gold medal. And then this girl, I had to go against her again for the open weight. So there's the weighted round where you get weighed and you have to go against people the same weight as you. And then there's the apron weight, you can go against anyone, any like size, doesn't matter. And so she was going against me again. And she just, you could see the look of dread on her face, like, oh God, because she hadn't won anything like all day. So I was taking her down to the floor. I was up on points. And then this, I could just see the panic in her eyes. Like she was on the floor. She was like, oh fuck. And so she just saw my knee and she kicked it. You're not supposed to kick in jiu-jitsu. Mm. And then I heard a pop. And it was the most painful thing I've ever experienced. And then I was full of adrenaline, Bruce. So I got back up there and I tried to take it down some more. But then it popped out again as soon as I stood up. So, yeah.
I heard people calling out during that.
Oh, my name.
I thought they were calling out. I thought that was her.
No, so my nickname in jiu-jitsu is Gentle.
Gentle.
It's a bit of a joke because I'm not very gentle at all.
What?
But I've not, you know, popped anyone's kneecap out. I've not broken any bones or anything. I'm just a bit rough. You have to be in this game.
Yeah.
I am innocent though. I'm a sweet, lovely person.
You are. Okay.